نحمده ونصلي ونسلم على رسوله الكريم اما بعد اعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم يا ايها الناس انا خلقناكم من ذكر وانثى وجعلناكم شعوبا وقبائل لتعارفوا ان اكرمكم عند الله اتقاكم ان الله علیم خبیر صدق اللہ العلی العظیم ان اللہ وملائکتہ یصلون علی النبی یا ایھا الذین آمنوا صلوا علیہ وسلموا تسلیما اللہم صلی علی سیدنا محمد وعلی آل سیدنا محمد اول کل شیء و اوسط کل شیء و آخر کل شیء الصلاۃ والسلام علیک یا رسول اللہ وعلی آلک و صحابک یا حبیب اللہ ریسپیکٹیبل آڈینس لسنرس اینڈ ویورس السلام علیکم ورحمۃ اللہ وبرکاتہ ٹوڈے دا ٹاپک از ایکویلٹی اینڈ فریٹرنیٹی ان اسلامک ٹیچنگ آئی ہیو ریسائٹڈ ورس نمبر 13 فرام سورہ الحجرات نمبر 49 بسم اللہ الرحمن الرحیم یا ایہا الناس انا خلقناکم من ذکر و انثی و جعلناکم شعوبا و قبائل لتعارفوا ان اکرمکم عند اللہ اتقاکم ان اللہ علیم خبیر او ہیومن کائنڈ وی کریٹڈ یو آل فرام اے میل اینڈ فیمیل اینڈ میڈ یو into nations and tribes so that you may know one another. Verily, the noblest of you in the sight of Allah is the most righteous of you. Surely, Allah is all-knowing, all-aware. Respectable listeners and viewers, in this verse, the whole of mankind has been addressed to reform it of great evil that has always caused disruption in the world, that is the prejudices due to race, nationality or other group affiliation. On account of these prejudices, man is in every age has generally drawn around himself some closed circles. And regarding those born within those circles, they are seen as his own people. They are seen as his own people and those outside the accepted group as others. These circles have been drawn on the basis of accidental birth and not on rational or moral ground. Born in a particular family, tribe or race, or in same particular region or in a nation having a particular ethnicity or speaking a particular language, these are the chance factors by which the circles are established. Superiority of one's own group, discriminations towards others involves looking upon one's own group as superior, and this has resulted in the worst forms of hatred, conflict and tyranny. New philosophies have been propounded based on such supremacism. New religions invented, new codes of law developed and new moral principles framed, so much so that nations and empires have made this distinction a permanent way of life. A supremacist mindset gave birth to class distinction among the Hindus, according to which superiority of the Brahmins was established, and all other human beings came to be regarded as inferior and unclean. एंड शूदर्स आर सब्जुगेटेड इन द डेप्थ ऑफ डिसग्रेस एंड डिग्रेडेशन. Jewish people regard themselves as the chosen people of God. Jewish people regard themselves as the chosen people of God. And even in the practice of their religious rites, look upon non-Jews as inferior in rank and human worth. It is a tragic irony that the concept of the chosen people and its conflation with superiority as claimed by Jewish people was ruthlessly matched by the supremacist ideology of Nazi Germany. Another example in the atrocities that have been committed against people of color in Africa and America on account of the white man's notion of his own supremacy. The treatment that the European meted out to the indigenous Indian race in America and to the weak nations of Asia and Africa has the same concept. Underlying it, these ethnocentrists thought that had the right to plunder the wealth of other peoples and take them as their slaves, exterminating them if need be to advance their agenda of exploitation. The verse under consideration shows that the only basis of surpassing merit and excellence is that of piety and moral elevation yielded by God. Consciousness. Now let us we see the rules and regulation of USA, United States of America. The USA Constitution states that everyone is equal, but many groups such as black Americans were not treated fairly. There was a great deal of prejudice against those who were not considered real Americans. Problem faced by black Americans. Number one, due to low wages, many black Americans were too poor to pay the tax and were therefore unable to vote. Number two, according to Jim Crow laws, white people and black Americans had to live separately. Number three, black Americans could not serve on juries. Number five, school for black Americans were deliberately kept inferior so they would remain uneducated and not advance in society. Racial intolerance affected every aspect of their life. Now we consider Islamic rules and regulations. A man once visited the Prophet mosque in Medina. There he saw a group of people sitting and discussing their faith together. Among them were Hadhrat Sulman radiallahu ta'ala anhu, who came from Persia, Hadhrat Suhaib radiallahu ta'ala anhu, who grew up in the Eastern Roman Empire and was regarded as a Greek, and Hadhrat Bilal radiallahu ta'ala anhu, who was an African. The man then said, if the Medinan tribes and of Aus and Khazraj support Hadhrat Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they are his people, that is Arab like him. But what are these people doing here? The Prophet became very angry when this was reported to him. Straightway, he went to mosque and summoned people to a salat. He addressed them saying, O people, know that the Lord and Sustainer is one. The Lord and Sustainer is one. Your ancestor is one. Your faith is one. The Arabism of any one of you is not from your mother or father. It is no more than a language or tongue. Whoever speaks Arabic is an Arab. Whoever has a pride in his heart of an atom, listen it again. Whoever has a pride in his heart of an atom shall not enter in paradise. In a hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "You are all the children of Hazrat Adam alayhi salam, and Adam was created from dust. Let the people give up boasting of their ancestors, otherwise they will stand more degraded than a mean insect in sight of Allah Azza wa Jal." In another hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Allah does not see your outward appearance and your possessions, but he sees your hearts and your deeds." Muslim and Ibn Majah. These teachings cannot remain confined towards only, as Islam aims to establish a universe brotherhood of the believers on such basis, disallowing any distinction on account of color, race, language, or nationality. I repeat this sentence again. These teachings cannot remain confined towards only, as Islam aims to establish a universal brotherhood of the believers on such basis, disallowing any distinction on account of color, race, language, and nationality, bestowing on all human beings equal rights. Even the opponents of Islam have had to admit that no match is found in any religion or any ideological system as to the principle of human equality and unity that has been given practical shape in the Muslim society. Respectable audience, Islam is the only religion which has united multiple races and communities. Islam is the only religion which has united multiple races and communities. Listen it again. Islam is the only and only religion which has united multiple races and communities scattered to all corners of earth into one universal ummah. Wama alayna illal balagh.